Hey guys! So today's video is going to be my April favorites because it's the beginning of May. It's gonna be May! And that's just what you do, right? Bringing it back. So I have a whole pile of things to my right that we're gonna talk about today. First being my new skincare. Let me casually just grab these. Just casual. I'm in love. So if you guys didn't see my video talking about my new skincare routine, I will leave links in cards and in the description below. But I've been obsessed with skincare from The Ordinary. I have the lactic acid 5% buffet, the organic cold pressed rosehip seed oil, and the caffeine solution, and I would definitely buy more. All of this cost me under $40, okay? Stuff like Sunday Riley, Good Jeans, fucking Drunk Elephant, all that shit costs like 80 bucks a piece, and these are like $8. Average. It's crazy. I love these. Definitely check out The Ordinary. I have been obsessed with them. And they just released foundations and I'm so excited because I'm like, I haven't been able to use a liquid foundation in so long that actually works. So I'm very intrigued to try it because Wayne Goss talked about it recently and I'm like, I trust Wayne Goss's opinion on foundations like nobody's business because I feel like he always uses foundation in a really, really beautiful way. The Ordinary, obsessed with it. So I bought a couple of the Urban Decay Special Effects Vice Topcoat things. There's too many names. The one I've really, really been enjoying is Copycat, which is this really pretty, like, corally rose color. There's like a little bit of green shimmers in there, but it goes on top of so many different colors. It goes on top of pinks, corals, reds. You can like blend it out with like a gloss and it looks really pretty. I bought this one and then Circuit, which is the green one, which I like too, but I like this one better. I find it goes more with other things. A couple of oldies but goodies. The NYX blush and taupe. Like, can you see how like jank balls this blush is? It is taupe. But it is a warm taupe. It is like a mauvey, warm brown taupe. It's the perfect contour shade for like pale girls like me that have like no olive in our skin tone. Like, it's all pink. So this is a perfect contour shade for people who have similar complexion to mine. If you have been wanting to try the Lunatic Labs contour kit, but you can't shell out like $70 for it, give this a try to see if the colors kind of work and this kind of shade works for your skin tone. And then if you like it, then you can splurge on that thing. I have had this for years and it looks like shit, but I love it. I don't even know if they carry this blush anymore, but I know they carry like the HD blush in taupe. NYX. A couple of the Milani purchases. This first thing I actually bought because everybody and their mother owns it on YouTube. This is Luminoso. The Milani Baked Blush. It's a coral. It's beautiful. It has this really pretty, like, satiny, you can't see that, like, satin finish that isn't matte, but it isn't shimmery. It's, like, somewhere in between, and it's gorgeous. It looks so natural on the skin, but, like, it still gives you, like, a flush. Like, I'm wearing it today. It's definitely, like, pigmented, but it doesn't look, like, abnormal on your skin. And then this lipstick is from their matte collection. I bought this solely because Kimberly Clark talked about it in her matte lipstick video, and I noticed that she didn't actually include all, like, liquid to matte lipsticks. A lot of them were, like, regular old, just, like, tube lipsticks, and I was like, I seem to have very similar taste to her, and she's obsessed with these. I went to Walgreens, and they weren't very expensive. I think they're like $6-something. The color is not true to this at all. It's definitely more like bright than what is on the bottom. Yeah, it's bright, but it is gorgeous. It is the most beautiful matte texture. It is very matte. How many times have I said matte? Take a shot every time I said matte, but you would die. It doesn't feel heavy on the lips, which a lot of times, like, matte lipsticks, especially ones from the drugstore, feel so, like, cakey on the lips. This feels so lightweight. It's beautiful.
Take a sip of my coffee.
One thing I purchased because I saw my buddy Carly from The Science of Chic talk about this brand on her Instagram, and this is Fuck Bad Vibes by the brand Anese. I don't know how to spell it, say it, whatever. This is a hydrating body and hair elixir. That's a super vague statement, but the ingredients are water, rose water, aloe, glycerin, and essential oil blend. So it's almond and sandalwood, so it smells like grandma soap in a really pleasant way. I don't know why. I love spraying it in my hair. Like, this whole bottle is 4 ounces. It was like $23, which isn't that crazy for like an indie brand, because usually something this size would be definitely more expensive. But since the first ingredient is water, I'm assuming that like it's not the most crazy formula. But it smells good, and I love that it's called Fuck Bad Vibes, so that's why I bought it. It smells so good. Now my hair smells, it's like a powdery kind of smell. It's really lovely. I like it a lot. A couple things from Lush. The Pink Peppermint Foot Cream is a lotion that does not get nearly enough love on YouTube or in the store, because it kind of like lives with the foot stuff that's kind of like low to the ground because feet. But this is a lotion. It's pink. It used to be called Fair Trade Foot Lotion. It makes more sense. It's so good. Like, it's so good. Not only good for your feet, it's good for sore muscles, it's good for cramps, it has arnica infusion in almond oil, it's got cocoa butter, it has two different kinds of mint. So hydrating. It smells like thin mints, but with like more spearmint. Oh, so good. One thing that I got from the newest collection that Lush launched is the Scrubee. It's a body scrub, body butter scrub. Smells like Honey, I Watch the Kids and Monge 2. It's a body scrub in a butter form. So it's like if they took Buffy, added way more granules and scrubby almond bits, and added honey to it. It smells amazing, and it's a bee. It's a bee. I love it so much. I bought one, and then I loved it so much that I went back the next week and then I bought three more. So now I'm set for a while. I do that now. So I did want to talk about a few YouTubers that I've been loving this month. First being Kimberly Clark, who I mentioned talking about that Milani lipstick. Kimberly Clark is a drag queen here on YouTube, and she started the anti-haul trend, and her videos are fucking hilarious. She's so just punchy and poignant and well-spoken and funny. Like, I love your videos, Kimberly. You're great and your makeup skills are awesome. And I will be doing an anti-haul. I've been collecting things in a list of like what I would do. If you guys have any suggestions for things that have been really enticing and have been really like marketed weirdly, leave them in the comments below and I will take a look at them to see if there's anything that I might want or dig deeper into why people might not need it. But Kimberly Clark, you are awesome. I love your channel. If you need some like anti-shopping therapy, check out Kimberly Clark because she will keep you from buying things that you don't need. Yay! Next YouTuber I wanted to talk about is Nikki Limo. And I've watched Nikki's videos for about a year now, but particularly in the last month, I have been loving her content, specifically because of all of the bean recipes that she's been coming up with. Or not coming up with, finding and then making and testing. It started with the black bean brownies, which I made last week, and they're fucking amazing. I will leave the video link in a card and the recipe below because it works, trust me. And then she made bean water cookies out of the water that you get with chickpeas, and then she made like chickpea cookies the other day. It's crazy. I love her channel, and she's funny and great and relatable as hell. So, Nikki, your channel is great. Another YouTuber that I've been binging hard, sometimes on accident, like I've fallen asleep while watching his videos after I like drank too much whiskey and then like fell asleep and woke up at like 3 in the morning and I was like, his videos are still playing. It is Internet Comment Etiquette with Eric. And Eric is so funny. He is the best kind of troll. I say troll in the nicest way because he goes on other people's videos and like, it's so complicated to explain, but if you like sassy, sarcastic humor, sometimes very dark, I highly recommend his channel. It's funny, it's witty, it's relevant, it's timely. I love his videos. He's great. And I particularly like the one he did recently about like hate, learning to hate. But like seriously, check out his channel. It's so good. And you can just get on like a binge of his videos. Like it can spiral, you know. One TV show that has been on fire this month is The Flash. I just got finished watching the latest episode where we find out who Savitar is. No spoilers, don't worry. But this month, Flash has been awesome. I'm so excited that like finally this shit is coming to like a close and then we're finally getting some answers and like, oh, like even though Killer Frost annoys the hell out of me, let me know if you want me to do a Killer Frost makeup tutorial too, because I have everything that you would need to do it. If you watch The Flash, let me know. Yeah, no. Flash has been on fire this month. I love it. So good. So this is gonna sound so petty, but like the disaster that was the FYRE festival, it was the greatest thing that's happened in the news all month. I don't know why it's so, I do know why it's so funny. It's schadenfreude. It's you're seeing like rich ass kids who spent way too much money on a music festival put on by Ja Rule in the year 2017 get fucked. Ugh! I will post a link to an article that is the best thing that I've read all month. It was from a person who worked on the FYRE festival and then she quit 6 weeks before it was supposed to go down because she knew it was gonna like fucking implode on itself. And the best part is that they didn't make her sign an NDA, so she just flat out told everybody everything. And it's so funny. Read that story that I link below and you will see what Ja Rule said, and it just makes you smile. I was like, see all these things? I was like, what the fuck is the FYRE festival? Cause I hadn't heard about it at all. And I am somebody who stays in the know about music festivals. And I was like, what the fuck is this FYRE festival? Oh right, because it was only promoted by Instagram models and Instagram influencers. Shouldn't you take that as like a red flag that like it's not legit? Or that like they don't know what they're doing when they're just getting like Instagram influencers? It's not like a clothing brand, okay? Standalone brands, yes, use Instagram to advertise it, to market it. Yeah, I get ads all the time. Sometimes I follow the pages, sometimes I click on them, that's fine. Music festivals need more than like hot models just sitting in the Bahamas being like, oh, this is lit. I could just go on even more about how much it made me laugh. I was tweeting about it. I've been using Twitter a lot more this month, so if you want to hear my daily ramblings, follow me on Twitter because I kind of neglected it for a while, but I'm back on it because I have been getting some joy from like giving backlash to the president and to like other crazy right-wing nutjobs. Almost so much so that I want to like get them to block me so then I could just like put it on a t-shirt. Like get the picture that says like, real Donald Trump has blocked you from seeing his tweets. I would print that on a t-shirt and wear it all the time. I would wear that shit like a badge of honor. Twitter's another thing. I will give you a song of the day though. Your song of the day is Delusioning by Duke Evers. We are currently working on their episode of Band in Seattle, so I'm super stoked on that because their show is really fun to attend, and the line cut with the concert. They were so good. I love them. They're so great. Duke Evers. Delusioning. Link to that will be in the description. And one last thing I do want to mention. As you well know, YouTube is kind of broken right now. And I know that you've seen probably a ton of creators and people you subscribe to making videos specifically for asking about Patreon. Now, I have a Patreon account. I don't even use it. Like I created it like a couple years ago and I don't use it because I just got really lazy, but I think I'm gonna start using it now and like have special things for patrons. So let me know in the comments if you would be interested in supporting me in that way, because while I don't make a ton of money on YouTube, it's been about a half of what I usually get in the last month or so. And that's real. Like it's happening across the board because of Adpocalypse, Restrictgate. Like it's just, it's happening everywhere. And a lot of people are losing their livelihoods because they can't monetize certain videos. While I don't use it as my primary source of income, it is helpful to have some extra funds here and there. And with the current numbers I'm getting, I would go like months and months and months without getting any sort of payoff from AdSense. So if you would be interested in supporting me on Patreon, let me know what kind of rewards you would be interested in, because I want to do something that you guys would actually want, because you would be giving me money. I wouldn't ask for a lot. It would just, I mean, you could do it by video or by month, whichever. I don't care. But let me know what kind of rewards you would appreciate if I were to actually start using Patreon again. It would be much appreciated because I could use the extra cash here and there, especially because YouTube has fucked up so many people's lives in the last month or so. It's great. So in the comments below, let me know if you've tried any of these products or what your favorite product of the month is. What's your favorite thing you heard from FYRE Festival? Just like, just leave comments. I love comments. I love reading them. I don't get enough and I love responding to them, and So if you haven't subscribed already, please hit that subscribe button. And if you have, hit the little bell icon. That way you can get notified every time I upload a new video. And check out my last video that I uploaded last week. It would be much appreciated. See you guys in my next video. That was weird. I apologize. I'm awkward.